Because it's so delicious, we have to wonder if watermelon could possibly be good for you. After all, it does seem like most things we love are terrible for us, so is watermelon one of those things? We're going to find out. One of the best things about watermelon is its high water content of 92%, which makes it a great alternative to plain water. And unlike many citrusy sports drinks, watermelon is not very acidic, so drinking the juice isn't likely to cause acid reflux or other stomach-irritating reactions. It also contains B vitamins to boost your energy levels and electrolytes to replenish nutrients lost as you sweat. Talk about a tasty way to prevent heat stroke this summer! Watermelon also contains a type of amino acid known as citrulline, which works wonders on sore muscles and has been linked to improving blood flow and keeping your heart healthy. If that's what you're interested in, you should know, the white flesh near the rind actually contains more citrulline than the pink bits. Studies have shown that athletes who drink watermelon juice before intense workouts have quicker recovery heart rates and fewer sore muscles the next day. Drinking watermelon juice may also increase overall athletic performance. When your body processes citrulline, it turns into another amino acid called arginine. While arginine has many functions, it primarily rids the body of excess ammonia. Since exercising releases ammonia into the bloodstream, having higher levels of this amino acid can significantly reduce muscle fatigue and exhaustion. In general, watermelon is pretty good for our bodies, but it is possible to have too much of a good thing.
This watermelon is delicious, by the way.
This fruit is one of the best sources of a phytonutrient known as lycopene, the antioxidant responsible for giving the flesh its characteristic red color. Consuming antioxidants may prevent certain types of cancer and promote heart health, but load up on too much lycopene and you may find yourself with gastrointestinal distress. Too much can cause nausea, diarrhea, bloating, and indigestion, but luckily, you can eat quite a bit before this happens. Just be aware. Anyone who needs to watch their potassium intake might also want to limit their daily watermelon consumption, as each cup of watermelon contains 173 grams of potassium. For most of us, that's only 5% of the daily recommended intake, but it's enough to cause a potassium buildup in your blood if you don't process this mineral correctly. That can lead to chest pains, irregular heartbeat, and difficulty breathing. Ripe watermelons not only taste sweeter, but they're actually more nutrient-dense too. The Journal of Food Composition and Analysis tested watermelons of four different ripe stages: white, white-pink, pink, and red-ripe. They found the unripe fruit had almost no beta-carotene and fewer nutrients overall, while the riper fruits had higher levels of antioxidants and vitamin C. So, how do you make sure to take home a ripe watermelon? It can be difficult to tell, but there are a few tricks to selecting a good one. When you pick it up, it should feel heavier than you'd expect. You should also give it a light knocking to make sure it returns a hollow sound. A dull thud means it's over or under ripe. Finally, if you turn it around in your hands, you'll find the spot where the melon rests on the ground. If it's a pale yellow color, you're good to go. Any other color and you may want to choose another melon. The watermelon detox plan is designed to flush toxins out of your body by eating nothing but watermelon for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Want a snack? Watermelon. Dessert? Yep, you guessed it, watermelon. Continue for 5 days and watch the pounds drop off. Considering that each wedge of watermelon has only 86 calories, you'd need to eat a whole watermelon or more each day to reach your day's safe minimum caloric intake. If you think this particular fad sounds questionable, you're right, it is. If you make it through the week without going watermelon crazy, chances are good you'll gain back the weight once you go back to regular food. According to Medline Plus, fad diets rarely result in lasting weight loss. And while watermelon has many vitamins and a small amount of protein and dietary fiber, you'd certainly be missing out on balanced nutrition during your detox week. Long term, it's best to add watermelon to part of your already healthy diet instead of relying on it as a magical weight loss solution. We would probably all agree that watermelon is a fruit, except for those who consider it a vegetable. Believe it or not, there's a lively debate about how to classify a watermelon. How did things get so complicated? Well, botanically speaking, watermelon is a fruit in the same way that a tomato is technically a fruit. The seeds develop in the flowering plant instead of the roots or leaves. Looking at watermelon from a different perspective, though, it's a member of the same family as gourd vegetables like cucumbers and pumpkins. Like other vegetables, watermelons are planted from seed each year, harvested in one fell swoop, and the remaining vegetation is removed from the field so the process can be repeated next year. You see how things are getting tricky? Join the debate if you like, or just go ahead and consider it whichever category you need for your food diary. Unless you live in Oklahoma, of course, where you'll have to concede it's a vegetable. Why's that? Watermelon was declared the official state vegetable in 2007. Most of us eat the red flesh and throw out the rest, but it turns out the whole watermelon is good for you. But just because you can eat it, that doesn't mean you should chow down right away. Consuming the rind requires a bit of prep work. Because it's tougher than the rest of the melon, most recipes call for removing the green peel first. Once peeled, use the rinds instead of cucumber in refreshing watermelon gazpacho recipes, or grate them and toss the shredded pieces into your favorite coleslaw recipes. They can also be softened up to make watermelon rind pickles or turned into candy. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more mashed videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.